Hi, my name is Callum Burke from FreeFXAsia.com. Today, I'm going to show you how to install the daily pivot point indicator that I've written using Metrader, and let's see how we apply that using the pound yen on the hourly chart. Okay, now let's move over to Metrader. As you can see, I've already got the pound yen hourly chart open up already here. Now, the first thing we'll do is let's click on the top menu, pull insert. Okay, I click insert here. As you can see, I'm going to select indicators, which is the first option underneath the insert menu. Under indicators, we'll select custom. Under custom, let's select daily pivot points. Okay, so the first time you select this indicator, the first thing you'll see is this pop-up window. Inside this pop-up window, you've got four tabs. The first tab called common, let's leave it the way it is. So instead, let's click on inputs. Now, inside inputs, notice there are three things here. The first thing is pivot set. Inside the pivot set, the default value is 1. 1 simply means that we want to set this as the daily pivot point. You know, for those of you who want to play with a few new things, you might want to set that as 2 for weekly pivot point or 3 for the monthly pivot point. But for now, let's just leave it as it is. The second and the third thing here would say show resistance and show support. The default value of set is to be true, indicated by number 1. For those of you who want to see the support line and the resistance line, you can leave it as it is. Personally, I may prefer to use, I would prefer not to show the support and resistance line. It just makes the chart look a lot busier. So to keep it simple for now, let me just go ahead and disable it. Okay, so to show how I go and disable this, what I'm going to do here is simply set the show resistance equal to 0 and show support equal to 0. So, moving forward, let's click on colors. Now, here's something that I've set as my own preferences, but having said that, feel free to change it to suit your background color and your own preferences. So, for example, notice that I'm using a white color background, and for that, I'm going to choose dark green for my central pivot point, which is this number 3 line here, and the rest of the support and resistance line, I've set that as olive color. Again, you can set these colors anytime, and you can change this anytime based on your preferences. Okay, so with that, I'm going to click on OK. So let me show you something different. Let me show you how this chart would look if I go back and enable the support and resistance lines for the daily pivot points. So the way it will do that is to simply double click on this dark green line. I get back the pop-up window again. Make sure I've clicked on inputs. And inside inputs, I simply go and change the show resistance as equal to 1, show support is equal to 1, and then I click OK. There you go. See, you've got the central pivot point over here, and then you've got the olive color lines above and below the central pivot point. That shows the support and resistance line.